Hello, in this video I'm going to talk about the average case time complexity of quickshot. So far I have talked about the best case and the worst case time complexity of quickshot. Average case time complexity is very much close to balanced partitioning. Balanced partitioning means that when the pivot element partitions the array into half, and if those half are having equal number of elements, then we say that the partitioning is balanced one. For example, in this example, this is the pivot element, 5 is the pivot element, and it partitioned it into two parts, and both of the parts are having same number of elements. So this is known as balanced partitioning. If I talk about unbalanced one, then that happened in the worst case when we got the time complexity as order of n square. I have talked about it earlier in some videos. It happens, the balanced partitioning happens when we are having two subproblems, one having 0 and one having n minus 1 number of element. And the zero element in we have when we already have this sorted input, which could be in ascending order or in descending order. And if we are taking as 10 or 15, the first element or the last element as pivot, then we will end up having 0 and n minus 1 subproblems. If we are taking middle element as pivot, then the list will be divided into two parts. When we are taking first and the last element as pivot element, then we will end up having two subproblems, one having zero number of element and one having n minus 1 element. If we take middle element as pivot, then this will be partitioned into two parts. The thing here is that if you take middle element as pivot, then the time complexity in the worst case, that is order of n square when the array is sorted, becomes lesser when we take middle element as pivot. I'll show you how. When we take 15 as pivot, then 15 is already on its correct position. And since 15 is already on its correct position, so there is no such elements which can lie right to the 15, because 15 is the largest element in this array. So therefore, we end up having 0 element to the right. Again, when we sort 15, then we take 14 as pivot. When we take 14 as pivot, then there are no such element which is bigger than 14. So we end up having 0 element in the right. When we'll take 13 as pivot, then there are no such element which is greater than 13. So we end up having 0 element to the right. So the recursive tree forms like 0 and minus 1, 0 and minus 1, 0 and minus 1 in this way. So this becomes unbalanced partitioning when we have the recursive tree having subproblems always like 0 and minus 1, 0 and minus 1, 0 and minus 1 in every iteration. If you are having these two subproblems, 0 and n minus 1, or 0 and n minus 2, it will be in the next step, and then it will be 0 and n minus 3, not n minus 1, then it is unbalanced partitioning. So this is unbalanced partitioning. Balanced partitioning is when we have this array and we have partitioned this array in two parts having same number of elements. This is known as the balanced partitioning. Average case is much closer to that. Example of average case could be having 5 elements to the left, then pivot, then 100 elements to the right. Or maybe 100 elements to the left, then pivot, and then 5 elements to the right. Another example could be 100 elements to the left, then pivot element, then 10 elements to the right. Or maybe 10 elements to the left, pivot, and then 100 elements to the right. And these are more example one element. If you are having even the one element, the left and then there is some pivot element and then 10 elements. So in this case also we can say that this is the average one, because this is going to give you the time complexity of order of n log n. The only case in which we will not get time complexity as order of n log n is 0 and n minus 1 when we have sub problems in every iteration as 0 and n minus 1. If we want to improve the time complexity of order of n square in worst case, then we can take middle element as pivot and we can solve the problem. Now let's try to understand the average case with the help of example, where we are having n number of element and that is divided into the ratio of 1:9. Left subtree is the ratio of 1 and the right subtree is the ratio of 9. Obviously this one is going to have lesser number of element as compared to the right subtree. Now these two subproblems will further be divided into their subproblems. This is divided into two parts. So if you divide it into two parts, then do the square of 10, you'll get n by 100, and then subtract 1 by 10 from 1 by 100 and you'll get 9 by 100. The same thing is done for this also. 9 by 10 is also divided into two parts, and you do the square of 10, you'll get 9 by 100, and then subtract 9 by 100 from this 9 by 10, you'll get this. Similarly, we are doing for the rest of the levels of the tree until we reach this. So this tree will end up very lately than this one, and this will end up very sooner than this one, because this is having lesser number of element than this one, so it will end up very sooner than this one. Now on each of the steps it will take some time. Quickshot is based on the partitioning of element. So it partitions the element by taking three pointers. Initially it takes the pointer as a pivot element, and then it takes another pointer, J pointer, which will compare all of the elements with the pivot element. So for that comparison, it will travel through all of the element in the list. So if there are n elements, so it will take n as time. So here the time taken is n. And here also it will be n. If you add this, you'll get n value. And if you add all of them, like n by 10 and 9n by 10 becomes 10n by 10, that is nothing but n. So it is going to be n, and same will be the case with all of the levels of the tree. But for these two values, the time is lesser than n, and the c is some constant value, and the time is here, it is lesser than n, because for this tree, for the left subtree, we ended up very sooner than this one. So it is taking lesser time because we are not adding the time from this part. We are adding the time only from this part, so it is taking lesser time. So the whole overall time is n. And if you analyze the depth of the tree, it will take log n base 10, the left part, and the whole will take log n base 10 by 9 if you do some calculations. So if you add it up, the overall time complexity becomes n log n of the average case. So in this way, the average case time complexity becomes order of n log n. And we were taking the ratio to be 1:9, and it is very much closer to balanced partitioning, because so the only case in which we are not having order of n log n is when we are having input in shorted order, and when we are taking the pivot element in that shorted order to be the first or the last element, then only we'll get the time complexity to be order of n square. So remember that the worst case can be solved by taking the pivot element as the middle element. And this is how we got the time complexity as order of n log n for the average case, considering the ratio of the elements to be 1:9. So I hope that it has helped you. So thank you very much.